In previous class, we already complete some question and answers in CW. Today, we will complete total CW for first lesson. Okay? In previous class, 13th question, we write in CW. Today, we write 14th question and answer. What is the 13th question and answer? Yes, preparation of khichdi. Preparation of khichdi. In previous class, we already complete that question and answer. Now, in this class, we will write 14th question and answer. Okay? Start. What is the 14th question given? Observe whether your mother cooks on a low and high flame. Discuss with your mother and find out the reasons. Write the question. Observe whether your mother cooks on a loaf and or low or high flame. Discuss with your mother and find out the reasons. Find out the reason. What is the question given here? Whether your mother, your mother. Observe whether your mother cooks on a low or high flame. Discuss with your mother and find out the reason. Some food items prepared in time. Some of the time, your mother keeping the stove in low flame. Why your mother keeping in low flame? When some items cooking time, your mother keeping high flame. The stove keeping high flame. Why like that keeping high flame and low flame? Ask your mother. Your mother saying reason for that. That is the answer for this question. Understood? Now I write the answer. Note down. My mother cooks food. My mother cooks food on a low flame. First point. Second one. The reason is the nutritional value of food. The nutrition value of food will be spoiled if cooked on a high flame. When we cook food items in high flame, on a high flame, the nutritional value of the food item are decreased. That's why our mothers preparing food items on low flame. In that time, the nutritional values are not decreased. Understood? This is the reason. And micronutrients. Now you say, what are the micronutrients? Micronutrients. We take little quantity of food items in every day. That item is called as micronutrients. All are known. Macronutrients. We take large amount of food items. Like components. Which components? Carbohydrate, protein, fat. That all are called macro. Macro means large quantity we take every day in our food. Micro means small quantity or little quantity. Which items called as micronutrients? Which components? Yes, vitamins, minerals. Micronutrients like vitamins, ascorbic acid, vitamins, ascorbic acid, folic acid are disappear. Disappear means we want in that food item. Which items? Vitamins, ascorbic acid and folic acid. In next class, means next lesson, in next lesson we discuss about these type of acids. What is the meaning of acid? What are the different acids we use in our daily life? In next class, already we complete first lesson and CW. In this session, we will complete the total CW for first lesson. In next class, we will start second lesson. In second lesson, we discuss about this type of acids. What are the acids we have in our daily life and what is the use of acids? Understood? In that time, I will explain about these acids. These acids present in our daily eating food. When we cook on high flame, these type of useful items are disappear. That's why we always use in cooking time low flame. Food cooks food on a low flame. In that time, these items, these food components, vitamins, ascorbic acid or folic acids are present in our eating food, means preparing items. Understood? Fourth point. So, cooking should be done on a low flame. Why are you keeping like this? Yes, the first lesson CW is completed. Understood? Once again, check yourself. Any mistakes is there in your question answers? Once again, keep the textbook one side and notes one side and check the spellings, main components names and some experiments also there. Starch experiment and protein experiment, like that. Experiments time, we using some chemicals names. Check the chemicals names with the spelling. Understood? Check yourself after you send to your adapter teachers. Your adapter teachers will check the CWs. Understood? This is the first lesson. What is the first lesson in 7th class science? Yes, food components. You learn more and more about food components. The main components are present in our daily eating food. Carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins. That all are called macronutrients. When we take little quantity of food items, that are called micronutrients, like vitamins, cereals and vitamins, minerals. And roughages, what is the use of roughages? roughages are called as dietary fibers. It is roughages are useful to our digestion food easily. Next one, what is the use of water? Water is used for digestive food easily. In digestive tract, when we drink water eating food time, the food is going through digestive tract. When we drink water in that time, the food will go in that tract easily. That is the use of water. And we have different test, fat test. When we take a food item, we rub with paper, the paper will become translucent, means oil is absorbed. That is the fat test. Next one, carbohydrates. When we take a carbohydrate containing food item like powder or paste, when we add some iodine drop, iodine, dilute iodine solution, it becomes dark blue or black. That is the confirmation test for carbohydrates. Next, protein test. Protein test, we want two types of solutions, chemical solutions. First one is 2% of copper sulfate. What is the formula of copper sulfate? CuSO4. C capital, small u, S capital, O capital, O4. Like CuSO4. 2% of. Here 2% means 2 grams dissolved in 100 ml. Next one, 10% of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. 10% means 10 grams of sodium hydroxide dissolved in 100 ml. When we add the protein containing food, this one and this one, means copper sulfate 2 drops and NaOH 2 drops, we keep like stirring, means when we mix clearly, in that time we get purple color or dark violet color. That is the confirmation test for protein. Understood? This is the what we learn in first lesson, food components. In next class we will start second lesson. Understood? Thank you. After noting time, you send your adapter teachers. We will meet in next class.